Our school will follow the Montessori method for this age group. To tell us more about a Montessori education, I'm pleased to introduce our board member, Sister Saba Haider. Sister Saba not only has over 20 years of experience as a Montessori teacher and director, but she is also the product of a Montessori education herself. Please welcome her to the podium with a loud salawat.
I would first like to thank Brother Abbas and Maulana Faizi to give me this opportunity to be involved in this noble venture. I am a Montessorian, and today I'm here to answer some of these questions about Montessori and what is it. So why did the Unity Academy adapt this model of education? The Montessori method, just to clear some misconceptions about it, is not just any preschool or not just any nursery school, but it is based on a philosophy and a methodology. And that methodology and philosophy is based on the child. And my heart warms to see many beautiful young faces in the audience because the school is for them. So what is the Montessori philosophy? It is a unique philosophy that's based on the individual needs of the children. The child is the most important part of this method, and all the work that the Montessorians do is for the child. So it is a holistic education, and it takes in consideration all the aspects of the child education, not just academics. Academics are just given in Montessori. Montessori children usually excel, and Montessori, in just a layman term, teaches above a grade level anyways. So what do we take in consideration? We take their psychology, their psychological aspect, their social aspect, their emotional aspect, and really greatly their spiritual aspect. One of the outcomes of Montessori education is the spiritual awareness in a child, how we are going to connect that spiritual awareness to an environment. It's very hands-on learning. And children learn by connecting with materials which are placed in a prepared environment. We don't call our classrooms classrooms. They're called prepared environments because they are meant for the children to come and explore. There are five major areas in a preschool prepared environment. And since we are starting with the younger group, what are those prepared environment? Areas, there is of course the mathematics, there's of course language, there's of course the cultural subjects, which would be your sciences, life and physical sciences, and botany and zoology is also introduced at a very young age. But with that, we have two other subjects that are very peculiar to Montessori, and they are called practical life, which is really the gateway to Montessori. What is practical life? It teaches them grace and courtesy, respect of self and respect of other individuals, respect of the environment and respect of community. And this helps the children to develop order, coordination, concentration, and independence, which is the ultimate goal at a primary level. We also have an area which is called the sensorial area, which is really introduction to geometry. The prepared environment looks very different from a traditional school because a traditional school, usually in preschool, would have a classroom that's very bright, and there would be colorful posters of animals and other characters. In a prepared environment in Montessori classroom, the shelves are very low. It's a child-size environment because it's made for the children. The teacher doesn't have a desk. You would never see a teacher in a Montessori classroom being on a desk. They blend in the room because they are there to serve the children. And the prepared environment is also very natural and very organic because it invites children to do a lot of reflection on what they are doing. So it's very hands-on activities. It also is very self-directed activities. Children should not be put in pigeonholes that all four-year-old need to learn mathematics, 1 to 20 numbers at this time in the morning. No. They have their own needs, they have their own thoughts, they have their own personalities, and they have their own abilities and capability. So what Montessori does, it, and a teacher connects these children to these different activities and invites them for exploration in the environment. Our classrooms are multi-age classroom, and that's the model that the Unity Academy has adopted. So we will have 3 to 6 years old. By the time they enter elementary, they are 6 year old students in one environment. What is the benefit of a multi-age classroom? The benefit is the younger ones look up to their elders, that they are the 5 years old. They're their role models. The older ones have a lot of opportunities for peer teaching. And it could be helping a younger child learn how to zip up their coat or tie their shoelaces, or how to blow your nose, or just to say their numbers. So these activities empower the older child in the classroom to be independent and be confident and be a leader. This is a very symbiotic relationship because the younger child at the same time looks up to a role model. And this environment invites a lot of good social responsibility opportunities for the children. Our curriculum, just like I mentioned, is a very interdisciplinary curriculum. So we do not have a specific block periods of time where they are going to do mathematics or geography or language. They work on many different activities at the same time. So for example, in a classroom of 20 students, there could be 3 students who are in the practical life area learning to how to pour water for themselves. And there could be 5 students working on 1 to 100 numbers. And there could be 3 students working on language activities. The job of the teacher is to guide them and facilitate this learning to happen in the classroom. And that makes it very different from a traditional classroom. It is a prepared environment, as I mentioned, and the classroom is really the workspace for the learners to learn. And that makes it very different as well. The second thing that I would like to answer today is this method compatible with Islamic guidelines or raising children. This method is not only compatible, but it is harmonious, because it rests on peace education. The method of Montessori is for the child and for the child to learn to be a good human being. We call it the construction of the self. So the Montessori teacher is not only concerned to teach academics, to teach mathematics or language, but her greater role is to make these children great human beings. So one of the outcomes is social responsibility, respect for external authority, which is so important in Islam, which is, and Islam teaches community service, which is another aspect of Montessori. So Montessori education is very much in keeping with Islamic values, moral growth, grace and courtesy, respect of self, environment and others, and moral values are very important in Montessori. Usually Montessori children are extremely respectful to each other and to the elders. And over the years, as they grow in this cycle, the seeds that are sown in the primary classrooms grow. And you can see in older students, in middle school and high school students, how they go up and take tasks that go back and serve the community. So very much in compatibility with Islamic values. How does the Montessori method teach independence and confidence? At a primary level, independence would be the ultimate goal for children who are 3 to 5 year old. So they start with learning how to be orderly, how to develop a sense of order. And order is in the cosmos. Order is in our religion. Order is part of society. So they learn that, and how to be orderly in an environment. That order leads them to coordination, and coordination facilitates concentration. Montessori children are known to have moments of flow, as it's called in neuroscience. Those moments of flow are uninterrupted focus time. And that concentration leads them to be independent learners. By the time they come to elementary, independence would be like what we kind of expect from our young first graders, and we take them to be where? The end would be to be global citizens. So independence is one, and how do they become confident? Since they're always peer teaching, they're always asking questions, the environment is a very safe environment to make mistakes. And we, the teachers, are always there to guide them, and we are always humble enough to admit our mistakes. Now, I'm a teacher, and I admit my mistakes almost on a daily basis in front of the children, because that makes us human beings, and that makes us who we are. So independence and confidence is one of the traits they learn by doing a lot of peer modeling and teaching and working with materials and presenting and giving their information to their classmates. Do Montessori students transition into traditional school easily? This is the most commonly asked question, and we are asked this question on a daily basis. I am also a Montessori mother, and I've worn many different hats during my career in Montessori. Montessori children are very academically advanced. So when they transition to any public or private school, they do very well academically, since they are very confident in their abilities, because they're always presenting and they were always sharing and they're always making those connections in the classroom. They have that ability to easily adapt, and they're very adaptable. I will give you a personal example of my children. My daughter was the only ninth grader left in our school because parents had lost faith in this method by then. And that's what parents, you know, when they feel that there's a very small community of children in seventh grade or eighth grade, they lose that faith and they want to transition them to the big social outside, which I would not recommend. So I kept my child there, and I was the only Montessori, so I believed in it and I kept her there. She was in a room of four other children and a ninth grader. That's the freshman year for high school. And she transferred in the sophomore year because we didn't offer Montessori program at that time to a high school that had more than 1,000 students. My child did not do very well, but excelled. And I was very humbled that one of her teachers approached me and asked her about her integrity and work ethics. Where did she get that? Of course, home plays a huge role. Montessori also works with home as partners. You are the primary educators of your children. We are there to help and facilitate. But Montessori children, whether they go in high school or go in first grade or sixth grade. A lot of them have transitioned. In public and private school, they do very well. They are people. They like to talk to other people. They are social. They are confident. And they have all the right tools with them that makes them successful out in the real world. So that was just like a little synopsis of Montessori tonight. We will have many other sessions, and I'll be happy to assist in any way I can. Thank you so much.